Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the United States. I just wanted to make a quick video, brothers and sisters, and I wanted to put a link below this to a video I made July the 17th, where the Lord had spoken to me about Texas. If you guys have followed me, I've been wanting to move down to Texas, but the Lord had been talking to me about going to Arkansas, north of Little Rock. And I made some videos of mentioning this, and I didn't really want to say too much because, I mean, I want to get 100% confirmation from the Lord, and also because I'm not telling anybody they need to move to Arkansas. But the video that I made, and I'll put the link below this video, starting at 9 minutes, I was talking about, the whole video I was talking about moving to Arkansas, probably, and I didn't want to. But that, you know, the Lord was showing me that the New World Order would take down the United States through Texas. And the Lord gave me two signs to confirm that. And number one was is that Governor of Texas, Governor Perry, said he would not shake the hand of Obama, which he did the day that I made that video, when Obama came to Dallas. And the second one was is Gardasil, which is this immunizations for warts, genital warts, and then Governor Perry had signed a law making it mandatory for all girls to take the shot, high school or whatever, and you know, one of his top advisors got $250,000 from the company that makes that medicine. That's why it was, you know, that's ultimately what would probably keep him from becoming president. That's one of the main reasons. And second reason, sometimes when he appears in public, he acts like he's drunk. Those things would keep him out of becoming president anyway. But anyway, brothers and sisters, you know, that Gardasil, of course, and vaccinations, immunizations, these are the kind of things that's going to be coming up with the Ebola, besides the fact that the Ebola virus has about a 50% mortality rate. There's also going to be, you know, they're going to come out with vaccines. They're going to come out with quarantines. They're going to have, you know, who knows if, you know, they would use this to bring in martial law, to have roadblocks. You know, it could potentially be, you know, the thing that brings down the United States, the Ebola virus. And you know, that's what I've been saying and other people's been saying for videos from way back, you know, people like Alex Jones, Infowars.com, been talking about for 10 or 15 or 20 years, you know, how will they bring down the United States? Will it be, you know, and I mentioned this in videos many times, will it be by some virus like the Ebola virus? Will it be by nuclear war? Will it be by, you know, racial civil war that they've been trying to foment? All of those things. They've been trying to foment racial wars, and through the media, through the government, you know, in the Fast and Furious, you know, with the drug wars. All these things the government is doing, you know, to try to collapse the United States and do away, because they know this is a stronghold of Christianity. It's a stronghold of, you know, middle class and democracy, actually representative republic. We are not a democracy. As they say, the definition of democracy, famously stated before, you know, is two wolves and a sheep voting over what's for dinner. That's democracy. But we have a representative republic. And that's really, you know, the greatest form of government that's been on earth by man. It's been the representative republic, which we have in the United States. And of course, the New World Order fears that. They fear Christianity. They fear the middle class. They fear, you know, educated common people that's not part of the royal blood or the global elite. And are not Satanist and members of the Illuminati and all that, the elite people, or their little minions, and thus they fill the police forces and the military. They've been purging our military leadership of those who will not fire on U.S. citizens, that's documented. They're purging the police of intelligent people. There's a famous police chief who is the police chief of, seems like it was Detroit or Chicago Police Department for 20 years. And he had written a book, forgot his name. He was saying that in the 90s or 80s, he was saying that all the police departments in the United States was, you know, they didn't want anyone with above average IQ. They wanted to have everyone with a lower than 100 IQ. And that, you know, this people that they can more manipulate, control, and you know, arm them, get them up all jacked up on steroids and lifting weights and make them into, you know, stormtrooper Nazis. That's what we're seeing, the militarization of the police. All that stuff's been going on. They've got the FEMA camps ad nauseum, you know, all the things that's going on. And they've been preparing. And then the question has just been, how will they bring in the New World Order? You know, how will they Because the quote on the back of our dollar bill is, you know, announcing the a new order for the ages, the new world order. It's written in Latin underneath that the pyramid with the all-seeing eye above it. But brothers and sisters, that whole saying is out of chaos, a new world order, announcing a new world order for the ages, or a new order for the ages. That's the whole sentence. And that comes from what they call the Cumae Sibyl. And this is oracle, like most people have heard of the Oracle of Delphi. That's a famous one. And these are these women who become possessed with a python spirit, like the woman that Paul cast the demon out of, the woman that kept following around saying, you know, these men are the come from the Most High God, you know, to show us the way. And they finally cast a demon out of her. It was a python spirit. That's the same spirit of Apollo. Now, in the book of Revelation, it tells us that the king over the bottomless pit, the prince over the bottomless pit, is Apollyon. In the ancient, and I've made many videos about this, in the ancient world, in like Greek plays, and they have copies of, Apollo and Apollyon are interchangeable. That's the same, one and the same, self-same fallen angel, is Apollyon and Apollo. So the beast of Revelation's name is written clearly in there. I have one video on my channel that is not mine. It's from Dr. Tom Horn. And the title I gave it was The Name of the Beast is in the Bible. And that's true. And Dr. Tom Horn is talking all the deep stuff about that. And there's, of course, there's always the people that are looking for the, you know, the MTV generation who are looking for the 30-second soundbite of who's the Antichrist. But the spirit of the Antichrist is, in the book of Revelation, he's called the Beast. The beast that came out of the bottomless pit, Apollyon, it says, will kill the two witnesses. Okay? When you read all these books left behind, whatever you want to talk about, the beast is the Antichrist. Of course, in the book of Revelation, he's not called the Antichrist, he's called the beast. The first beast. The first beast is Apollyon. Apollo, the ancient god Apollo. And his oracle, some women possessed by him who spoke for him, one of them said, this poem about the return of Apollo. You go look it up. You can go find it on Google it. It's a poem saying that, you know, in the days of Apollo, when he'll return, he'll come back. And in those days, you know, and then part of that poem says, and out of chaos, a new world order is born, or something like that. And that is the exact quote that's on the back of our $1 bill, brothers and sisters, in Latin. So that's their plan. That's been their plan. I made tons of videos about that. A little bit here and a little bit there. Anyway, so brothers and sisters, I want to put a link to that video of what the Lord was speaking to me in July about how Texas would be the place. I don't know if this is it, but you have already told me Gardasil, so that connects to vaccines, you know, epidemic stuff. So maybe this is how it's going to happen, brothers and sisters. We all know this is coming. All of those who are awake, you're on the internet watching videos, we're awake. We know, you know, that something's got to happen, you know, to bring the Antichrist to power. Well, yeah, as I say, whether it be World War III or a combination of World War III, Ebola outbreak, the Rapture, all, you know, tsunamis, all these different things people talk about, volcanic eruptions, you know, all the things that Jesus said in the beginning of Matthew chapter 24. You know, there'll be wars and rumors of wars, you know, famines and pestilences and earthquakes in diverse places or various places. And this is the beginning of sorrows. You know, we're seeing that. And it's been going on and increasing. But you know, it's hitting home now in America. You know, this is one of those things, just like in Ferguson. I watched the situation in Ferguson, and you know, I don't get caught up in what the media is talking about. I'm looking at, will the government take the situation and make hay out of it? You know, as Rahm Emanuel said, you know, and Hillary Clinton has been quote, you know, said on video, you know, you can't let a good crisis go to waste. You know, will they take advantage of this crisis and bring in martial law? Stir up, you know, civil wars between, you know, black Americans and white Americans, start some kind of thing, an excuse where they have to bring in martial law, confiscate people's guns and all that, bring in the new world order, leading into the tribulation period. Is that what they're going to do? Will it be, you know, the Ebola? Will they take advantage of that? Are they the ones who engineered and spread the Ebola? That's what lots of people believe. Just like AIDS. It's been famously said that, you know, AIDS was, you know, genetically engineered it was militarized and weaponized to wipe out homosexuals and minorities. And that's, you know, that's been said by lots of people. You know, even people in the medical field who are epidemiologists and scientists say they believe these, you know, like this other virus too that was spread, some bird flu and that H1N1, whatever it was, all these viruses, there are lots of experts who will tell you these things had to be engineered. You know, there are experts in that field, and they say these things are not naturally occurring. Somebody has weaponized this. Who has weaponized these diseases? Of course, it's the United States CIA, you know, DARPA, defense, you know, whatever it is. DARPA is, you know, it's the defense research stuff. They're the ones doing it. They want to create chaos to bring in the New World Order. So, as I was talking to a brother today, and, you know, we were talking, and as a matter of fact, the brother lives in Dallas, and his wife is a nurse there in the hospital system where the guy with Ebola is at. He's going to give me updates. I don't want to pull Paul Begley and come on here breaking news. I'm not CNN, and I'm not trying to be CNN, so I don't want to really get into that sensationalism about it. But by the grace of God, we don't become a showman, but be a servant of God. Praise God. But anyway, brothers and sisters, I was talking to this brother, and I was saying, you know, I heard an epidemiologist saying a few weeks ago on a radio interview saying that, you know, they will probably try to weaponize this Ebola, even if, you know, it may already be weaponized, whatever, they've allowed it to spread. But I mean, when I say weaponized, they will help it mutate, or it will mutate, or they will help it mutate to become airborne. And right now, the Ebola is not airborne. It is, you know, spread by fluid contact. Someone spits and then you get it in your mouth or blood or, you know, whatever, through the urine. I don't know if whatever, some way. You could get that in you, then you would get it. You know, so, you know, someone handles something with spit on their finger and then you touch it and then you put it in your mouth. But anyway, it's not aerosol. It's not spread by breathing. And that's the good thing. But I'm sure it will become that way, and they'll be the ones who are weaponizing it, brothers and sisters. The government themselves. They want to kill all people. I mean, that's what they're doing. Like the Georgia guy Stone, what people have been talking about. I usually don't get into all this stuff. Even though I made videos pointing at all these things, brothers and sisters, I try not to go into current events directly, even though, you know, I wanted to do that when I started YouTube, but the Lord always leads me to preaching, you know. And then you end up getting unreliable information. I would say almost every breaking news video that I've watched, which is not many, because I get my news from directly from websites, not from someone who saw it on a website and then made a video about it. Half the time, it's been ended up being rumors and speculation and not true. So, you know, we have to guard ourselves from what's being said, whether it be true or not, even though things are bad and things are maybe worse in some ways than you know. But there's also tons of speculation, brothers and sisters. So we have to keep ourselves calm. We have to keep ourselves calm, cool, and collect, brothers and sisters, because, you know, it's we have the Lord, of course. And I just want to say this, because, of course, you know, we pray that the Lord would give us the grace. And there's lots of Christians, especially, it seems to be those who are the most immature, will make the statement, well, you know, the Lord is with us and the Lord's going to deliver us. That is totally true. But when you are in the middle of that crisis, if God doesn't pour out a spirit of grace on you, you know, suppose just, you know, and I can say this from experience, like Joshua got, you know, dengue fever and died. And of course, the Lord gave us the grace to go through that. But if you're in that situation and you find out, oh, your kid's got Ebola, or, you know, your wife has Ebola, or your husband has Ebola, you know, or your grandkids, you know, it's all, you know, just talk when people are, you know, in theory and all up here when people are talking about, oh, you know, the Lord is with us and all that. You know, these things that happen to people are real. This is, you know, that's the problem with, you know, modern day, you know, cable TV, television, and now the internet and all the things that people have, they become desensitized. You know, I forgot what it is. By the time a child reaches 18 years old, they've seen, you know, 20,000 murders on TV, you know, violent acts, all the cussing and all this. People have been desensitized. Again, I go back, of course, I'm not that old either, the MTV generation. Thank the Lord I didn't get caught up into it. I've never liked MTV since the day they started it. I thought it was foolishness. I mean, you know, just nonsense when I was a teenager. Thank the Lord. But, you know, people have just so desensitized, and they keep talking about, well, you know, what's going on with somebody else, like it's no big deal. But when it hits your house, you know, like they call it not in my backyard syndrome, you know, when it comes to your house, death, the angel of death comes to your house, you know, then that's when all of those cliches and all of that, you know, inch a mile wide and an inch deep conversation is meaningless, brothers and sisters. When it really comes down to it. That's why I'm always on here teaching about, you know, being rooted and grounded in the Word. And then, of course, keep seeking the Lord and be filled with His Holy Spirit. Because, as an example, brothers and sisters, let's look at this. Let's just suppose that this old Ebola, you know, could break out and cover the whole United States, and then they quarantine everybody. Okay, so, you know, they won't let them transfer fuel. There could be a point, you know, you can't get to the grocery store. Then the electricity goes out. You know, it's possible. It's just some scenario where it ends up that the electricity is cut off. You can't go to work. You can't pay electric bill. They can't get coal to the electric plant or whatever they're using, and then there's a break in the electric. You know, the working crews can't go out to fix it because there was a storm, so the power's out in your region, and the repairman can't go out because everybody's quarantined. Let's use that. You know, you're cut off from the internet. You're cut off from everything. You're cut off from calling your pastor or me. You can't call me. I'm the pastor to a lot of you. Praise God for that. And there are many of you, of course, who watch me who also go to a church. But you're cut off from everybody. And so you are your only source. You are your only source in connection to God. Not to watch videos or call me or email me or your pastor and get advice. Here you are cut off. And all you've got is your Bible and then yourself. You know, and then everybody in your house and your neighborhood's got Ebola. You know, and then what do? That's when you need the Word of God inside you. That's when you need the Holy Spirit inside you. That's what I've been trying to tell you guys since I got on here in July 2011. The day is coming when the poopy's going to hit the fan. And this is an example. This could be it. Maybe it won't be by the grace of God. I don't know that. But you have got to be prepared to function as the only preacher and the only Bible that these people's going to meet. You know, I've given a word to my parents. My parents are backsliders, extreme backsliders. Depends on your denomination. I would call them not saved at best. And I've given a word to my mom about 7 or 8 years ago before I went to the Philippines. And I told her, you know what, you need to read your Bible. You need to go to church, you know, and read your Bible. That's really before YouTube. And read your Bible and pray and all that. Because look, you know, and I gave her a word from the Lord. That disaster will come to this place. And all of our neighbors, most of the neighbors that we have are not Christian. And then you are going to be the most Christian person in this whole neighborhood. And they're going to be people dying. Your neighbors could be dying. In this case, Ebola, I thought of like earthquake or, you know, whatever it may be, hurricane, floods, whatever. Your neighbors are dying of Ebola. And then they're not saved. Then you going to go to their house into the Ebola environment and take care of them. And while you're there, you're going to be evangelizing these people who are dying. They're going to go to hell if you don't go over there into the contaminated environment, risking your life, walking by faith, and going over there and ministering to them about the Lord and leading them to salvation before they die. This is a reasonable expected scenario until the rapture happens, even after the rapture. If you watch this video and you're going to miss the rapture and be left behind and you become a tribulation saint, you're going to find yourself in this position every day until you die and get killed during all the wars and nuclear wars and tsunamis and earthquakes and not taking the mark and be arrested and have your head chopped off, all as the Bible says. All those things. In the meantime, it's going to be hell on earth and war. It's going there. It's going there. You must be prepared. You must know the word. They're going to confiscate people's Bibles. Can you imagine, though, if you go to your neighbor's house, he's dying of Ebola, even if, let's say, it's next week. Everybody's locked down. No internet, all that. No telephone service. You go to your neighbor's house. They're not saved. They're dying of Ebola. No help's coming. You go in there, and then you don't have time to, oh, let me go look in my Bible and research how to tell this person about Jesus. Oh, let me go in my Bible and see I can pray for them to be healed and to get saved. No, that's over with, guys. That's what I'm trying to tell you. You have to be prepared. You must have already been prepared. Read your Bible right now. Read the whole New Testament. Read the New Testament from start to finish. If time runs out and you see that it's going down, read Romans. Read Galatians. You know, read those epistles, especially the epistles of Paul. He breaks it down simply and easily in there about about the Word of God. Go for it. I'm going to go, guys. God bless you guys. I'm going to come back. I want to make some preaching. And, of course, I guess I got into a little bit of preaching here. You know, I love you guys. And, you know, the Lord did tell me, as I mentioned in videos in the past, and I didn't want to say it too much, as I said, to go to Arkansas, especially north of Little Rock. And the Lord told me it would be a safe haven. And, you know, maybe this is connected to what's going on now. I don't know. Maybe, you know, whatever. That's true. And I'm just watching and waiting and listening for the Lord. And I'm, you know... I'm looking at, I will go there at the beginning of November, but if it need be, I'll go before that. In the next month, I'll still be here. I'll be watching and waiting and praying and seeking the Lord about going at any time, and I will announce it when I go. But, you know, I'm not telling anybody to go there. I'm just telling you what the Lord told me, and it's up to you, whatever you wanted to do. But God bless you guys. I love you guys, to all my brothers and sisters in Dallas. I love you guys. You know the Lord is with you, of course, and the real bottom line, you know, true, of course, if we're going to die tomorrow, you know, to be absent from the bodies, to be present with the Lord, of course. We don't have any fear. And that's what I don't, you know, like about, you know, some of these channels. They're getting everybody all psyched up and pumped up. And half the time, what they're quoting is just rumors anyway. Get people all fired up and all this. And sometimes people are full of fear. And, you know, the God's not about that. It's about, yeah, fear of the Lord. Jesus said, don't fear somebody that can kill you, but fear the one who can throw your mind and body, you know, into hell, soul and body into hell. So we should only fear the Lord. But we need to, you know, get right with the Lord. And then once we're right with the Lord and we're walking with the Lord, of course, then our fear of the Lord is more respect than fear. Fear for the lost and judgment. But once we repent and get right with God, hey, we're walking with the Lord. We don't fear Ebola. We don't fear martial law. We don't fear those things. But we need to use common sense and be prepared. And we must be prepared, as I'm saying in this video. The point is that you're prepared to be a minister. Prepare to be a light and salt. And that you should have already been doing. 90% of you guys who are watching these videos, you ain't never done nothing in your whole life for the Lord. You know, and lots of people are on here debating and trolling on YouTube and never done anything for the Lord but go around and, you know, and dogging out, you know, some preachers that maybe need to be dogged out, whoever they may be. But God didn't call us to be on here as, you know, the police of what all these preachers said and didn't say, attacking men of God, and some of them are not so men of God. But we've been called to be salt and light in the world and to bring the good news to the lost and to the world. And myself, I've been called to disciple you guys, to help you guys be salt and light. And so praise God. I love you guys. I'll be back later with a video. God bless.